guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And even before you can continue, you can subscribe there so that you can be able to get a video anytime that I upload. Today I want to talk to ladies who want to travel to Saudi Arabia, because as you know, there are many cases there, as we see in the media, people talking of mistreatment. There are many girls that are said to be in the deportation center. Therefore, I want to talk to those ladies who are in Kenya. Even before you can travel and go there to work as a housemaid, you can be able to know the procedures that are supposed to be followed, and also you can know whether you are using the right agent or not. So these are the signs that you are not using a registered or you are using a wrong agent. First, if you are not taken to the training, you should know that you are not using the right agent. So if you get an agent who tells you that it's not a must that you undertake a home care training, then you should know that it's a red alert. And then it's also good to ensure that you are between 21 years to 45 years. So if you are below 21 years and the agent is saying that he can be able to help you, probably he's a fake agent or he's not licensed by the National Employment Authority, because the system that has been put in place, the Musaned system, cannot allow ladies who are below 21 years. Probably what he can do, he can change your years in the passport so that it can appear as if you are 21 years. Another issue that you should know, if your agent has not any physical location, there is no office, you cannot trust such a person. So if your agent has not any physical location or there is no office, then you should be very cautious before you travel using such an agent. So another thing that you should know is that you should travel to Saudi Arabia using a contract. You should have a contract. And I have been saying this, and I'll continue to say this, and I can insist on this. Please, before you travel to Saudi Arabia, ensure that you travel with a contract. Do not use cleaner's visa. There are some ladies who travel there using cleaner's visa instead of housemaid visa. And most of the time they do this because they have not undertaken mandatory training, and therefore they want to shortcut there. They want to go as a housemaid in disguise of cleaners. That is very dangerous, because it means your data has not been captured in the NEA system. It is also not captured in the embassy portal. And therefore, in case of a problem, you may not be able to be assisted quickly. So do not allow to be taken to Saudi Arabia without training and with a cleaner's visa. You should use a housemaid visa, and you should ensure that you travel with a contract. In the contract, it highlights the rights and the duties of both the employer and the employee. And also you find out that the salary is listed there. So if you are planning to go to Saudi Arabia, ensure that you use the procedures that has been put in place by the Ministry of Labor. Another issue that I want to highlight, there are those ladies who are working in Saudi Arabia. Some of them have, they ran away from their homes. Most of them, they are court care boys. And therefore, there are those ladies who reach in Saudi Arabia, even without any problem, they just decide to run away. You can find yourself in a problem, and you should stick to your home. And if there is a problem, the agent that you use, if you use an accredited agent, it is able to be changed from one home to another. So those who are interested to join January intake, all that I need is I need a copy of your parents' ID. I also need your ID, and I also need a birth certificate so that you can be able to process passport. And there is also a training take 3 months and 4 days. So the whole process will take, it will take 1 month and 2 weeks. With that, you have done with the process, and you have used the procedure that have been put in place by the Ministry of Labor. Also ensure that you are medically fit, because we have only 3 clinics that has been approved by the Embassy of Saudi Arabia. And if you have a problem during the main medical, you cannot be able to travel. So ensure that you are medically fit. Age, we need people who are between 21 years to 45 years. 45 years and 21 are inclusive. And also we can also speak to our parents, because we are licensed. And it's good that your parents are able to know that you are traveling to Saudi Arabia and are good hands. Okay. So guys, continue to subscribe so that anytime that I upload a video, you can be able to follow up, and you can be able to get help. So you can reach me through 0710-256-883. That is my number. You can WhatsApp me between Monday to Friday. Please, Saturday, guys. Saturday and Sunday are my days for relaxing and also resting. So any day, Monday to Friday, and you should not call me past 5 o'clock. Okay. Thank you, guys. God bless you. And please do not forget to subscribe. Bye.